It is repetition which makes for perfection.
I'm thinking Gargoyle. And Batman. Batman's knee, thigh. I don't know what that means. Alright. I don't normally construct a figure this way, but why not? I'm already hating this. But why not? It's actually like the Batman 608 cover I did. Just the camera moved from a side angle to more of a front angle. Tricky part will get kind of blown out. 80 years, what's he doing? Is he looking at his watch? He could be doing that. He could be checking the time. He could be holding the cape across his chest. Kind of looking a little over his shoulder like this, like he's looking down at the city that way instead of at us. Light distinction. But yeah, he's great. Great actor. Actually, when I first saw Game of Thrones, I thought it was Richard Chamberlain. I was like, that's not possible. He could not have stayed this young for so long. Okay. So we have a slight three-quarter on the chest. I find that when you break up the body like this into kind of these planes, it tends to kind of stiffen up the figure. So while you may be like kind of crystallizing structure, it actually kind of makes the characters look less dynamic. Yeah, we got like 880 concurrent. That's not bad for not having streamed in a while. However, I have to find the next gen Crispy, next gen Kirihiko. But they are brave hearts, die hearts. That was like Last Jedi, like 6 months later. Still, I have not seen it. Please do not discuss. Bitte warten. All right, let's see. To Blow Marvel. Yes, I am a Star Wars fan. I definitely saw the trailer. Look good. Look really good. I'm looking forward to the conclusion of the trilogy. Problem with like a 0.4 pencil is that it's very sharp, but it's like a same thing with 0.3 is that it It's so sharp that it's hard to just kind of loosely pencil. It has ears. Word's still out on that gargoyle. I might have to Google a gargoyle to kind of reset my internal vision of what a gargoyle looks like. I'm going to loosely erase all this up here and seek to add a little more dynamic movement. Maybe a little bit more exaggeration. Maybe. What about that? Bit of a turn. And then, with this arm going back into space, oh, hey, we have an elephant. Three mods back. Or always gets old. Gets older. Oh my gosh. I like everything but that arm. I kind of like the idea that there's like this weird tilt to his body. And, could be doing Elvis kind of thing. I think I did this cover, a variation of this for a variant cover. Easy to put a grappling gun here. But it's such a specific kind of pose, like if I do this, kind of like perfect. All right. I think what I'm going to do is do an upshot on the gargoyle. That would be kind of cool. Wait, are all the bridesmaids and groomsmen? It's like one side Marvel, one side DC. I need to know more. Is that a gorilla gargoyle? No. It could be. I haven't really decided it's going to be anything. I just broke down the structure. So it's vaguely humanoid. But call up Brad and see what's going on. How's that game coming along? All right, let's just try for the sake of argument. grappling gun. And we will put buildings behind him. Gotham. Let's do this. Give ourselves a little bit more of a blueprint, safety net. That helps a lot. Being able to see what you're drawing. Highly, highly recommend it. See, I'm kind of drawing by pieces because I'm still measuring it up as opposed to just kind of, there are no pencils really. I'm just drawing with ink. Probably not the wisest thing to do. But I'm still doing a lot of mathematical kind of comparisons. Is riding up a little high, but it's okay. I'm not too worried about it because the shadow's going to go this way. And because of that, when I go into this area, it's all going to go. Eyes all messed up, but I'm gonna white it out anyway. Kind of a sense of where all the this is going to go here in the center area. This is a 0.4 micron. I'm barely trying to touch the surface to get the thinnest line possible. My values here. Bedad humor right there. I couldn't help it. I just reflexively could not stop myself. Sorry. All right. Probably need to. Get rid of it for now, though. Throwing off my construction here. I think I decided I'm going to do most of this with the micron, as opposed to, like, sometimes I'll go in and spot shadows and stuff with the brush early on. Let's see what happens if I just render this as much as possible with the micron to start. Where that kind of leaves me. knowing, of course, that the light source is over here. Now, the problem with using whiteout is that you can no longer look at it reversed through the retro. That is the one liberating thing about kind of pencil inking your own work, is that it's very easy to fix your messes. Jump to the gun. Huh. More dad humor. Jump to the gun. Jump the gun. Just in case you want to know, I write all my own material. There's no one that helps me with this. Oh my god. My eyes. What the heck is happening? Mother Nature. I don't know if there are any people that are older than me in this stream, but if you are near my age, you can appreciate what I'm like. I don't have to clip my toenails anymore for whatever reason. They stop growing. Unlike my sons, my 5-year-old, the 7-year-old, I mean, I remember as a kid, that was just an awful feeling, right? Whenever your parents like clip your fingernails, doesn't. I'm not sure if this eye is in the right place. know if you guys have caught any of the Batman 80 celebrations. Obviously, Detective 1000 was a big part of it. They're re-releasing a bunch of the movies. Tim Burton, Christopher Nolan movies. And then there's other activations planned, which will be announced. If you go to Batman80.com, I think it has a continual kind of list that they're updating. And one of the things I get to do is our heroes, taking the hero to the heroes. Going to visit some military bases for that. Never done anything like that, so can't share the locations or where I'm going. It's a struggle at times. I'd say the only time it's super easy to draw is towards the end of a deadline when you've been drawing like nonstop for like days after days, just kind of flying by, kind of muscle memory. All the stuff that normally kind of gets triggered when you're drawing, so the stuff that tells you like, nah, that doesn't look right, redo it. It gets kind of blunted or kind of stepped on because you're just trying to, you're in that zone. You either don't see it or you don't want to see it. And the pages go easier. They just have more energy. Good to show this on camera. You know, I was watching some how-to videos, on YouTube. There's a lot of artists out there. And you know what struck me is that watching someone draw something or paint something and learning how to do it, or watching and understanding conceptually what's going on, see how it creates a pleasing kind of abstract version of an eye that my mind reads as an eye. But whether I can sit down and do it myself, probably 100% no. And then I started thinking about why that is and how that could be changed. And I thought probably because... one, it's going too fast. and two, they're not explaining why they're making the decisions they're doing. And three, it's kind of overwhelmed by all the other information you're taking in on the rest of the panel. Like, you know, sometimes you go, oh my gosh, I'm drawing or painting an eye. So it immediately, you're carrying all this sort of expectation of what you're creating should look like. You know, same way if you're drawing Batman. But if you're a professional artist, you should be drawn every day. My understanding is that they're not like the healthiest things to kind of drink. There we go. Let's just pretend I'm doing it again. Here, hold on. Sorry. There. That's what you missed. See, we'll often just smear out over the stuff I've already drawn. I'll lean into that a little bit. We need some buildings. I'll be watching Game of Thrones for sure tonight. And my Tyrion Lannister cosplay got it all set up. I think I mentioned that I was gonna. I had only seen the first season, which I really liked, and so I couldn't make it past two or three episodes of the second season. I tried like two or three times. So all this other time with all these other things going on, the Red Wedding, all the shame, all that stuff, I missed it, missed out. And I knew that it was building towards this epic conclusion. So my wife and I vowed to try one more time, and so we pushed on. We started from the very first season, rewatched that, and it was amazing. They actually introduced in that even the first several episodes. You just don't pick up on it because it's just too much information. But they drop you in right away. Yeah. Speed with it all. Shadows, lots of shadows. Wish this brush could hold more ink. It's not a very good brush. I have not seen Santa Clarita Diet. It's hard to stay current with all the shows that are. Very late in Germany. I like that contrast of the black wing against the underlit city behind it. Throw a little more ink onto the page. This way. kind of small quads. Fix this again. Let's add that eye back in there. Gun here, the grappling gun. Ears. Till it's finished. Okay. Ask Mama.
Mom said to ask you.
Okay, when I'm done, I'll come find you, okay? Plays Fortnite. He's pretty good at it, actually. On the keyboard. A grad right here. That kind of follows the muscles there. The kneecap down to the shin. Down to the calf here. And we'll do the same thing over here. Okay. All right, I'll one. Two, three, four, eggs. Da, da, da. Well, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to work for 15 minutes, and then I'm going to stop. And then just post up the results, or do you guys want me to finish it on a stream? I have dad responsibilities here. We lock all the kids out of the computers because otherwise they would never do anything else but game. And we've already made the side. feels a little bit like Ronin. If you ever read that Frank Miller series, it's awesome if you haven't read it. When it came out, I didn't quite understand it. I was probably too young for it. But in the years since I've reread it several times, it's awesome. It's a great bit of storytelling, a lot of fun. And then there's this pull-out fold that we kind of replicated again in All-Star Batman and Robin, which just blew me away as a kid, you know, as a teen. Come in here. Let's fix this head by make the head a little smaller. That'll make his body look bigger. See what happens when that happens here. Haven't figured it out. That's in August. So, just give you a rundown. My next show is in Dallas, which is, I think a half day on Saturday. Realistically, another 3 hours left in this piece. I've got to go in. Here, I'll show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to go in and add detail here. So I'll go in and clean. Like, I'll take these kind of very blunt sort of shadows and make it look like I actually filled in a trapped space versus just kind of using the side edge of a brush. And then I'll add little bits of rendering like this to add texture and to kind of fool the eye again into seeing heavy shadows. Just adding a little more finesse to these shapes so they turn into things as opposed to just kind of white and black shapes on a page. So that in itself will probably take like half an hour to an hour depending. And then I want to add rain and splatter. There's going to be rain coming this way. So there's all sorts of polish that I have to go around. So even like this texture or this level of rendering, see this dark gray right here, this dark gray into black. I'm going to transition it through here, into here, and also into here. So there's just more kind of general modeling that has to go around, just balancing out the gray values through cross-hatching, right, like this. And then there's going to be rain lines going this way and then splatter. I got to do whiteout effects here in the windows of the buildings. And I'll probably do a grappling gun line with whiteout and ink kind of going off here. So there's stuff to be done. So, but I will do it on stream probably later this week.